But we're also going to be witnessing some incredible power outage coming up here in a second. This has been built up, and it's a fun event, but it's been built up quite a bit, and it's received a lot of notoriety, but this is what we're going to call the World Championship Isabel-Off.
Yes.
A little background information. We've got Dave Lipson, who is a former professional football player, or excuse me, baseball player. And we also have Josh Everett, who's very, very well known in the CrossFit community. He's placed in the top three in the CrossFit games twice. He's done that. Just an incredible athlete. He's now working with the Special Forces in their strength and conditioning programs. But these two athletes have the fastest known times of Isabel.
He's going to do Isabel, 30 snatch at 135, from ground to overhead. It could be power snatch, squat snatch, split snatch, whatever it wants to be.
Pretty much prison rolls. And no holds barred, 30 reps, fast as you can with 135.
You know, Josh is competing tomorrow in the open event, so he told me, you know, he says, obviously, this is not what you want to be doing the night before a big competition.
Yeah, but it's Josh Everett. I mean, he's one of the strongest men in CrossFit, if not the strongest men.
If anybody's going to come in and still win the event tomorrow, it would be Josh.
And if there's anybody that's not going to let something like this shake him mentally tomorrow, it's going to be Josh Everett.
Exactly. And then, of course, Lipson's following that up and competing on Sunday.
Right.
But it was funny because Josh, I was talking to him about this event, and he jokingly said, you know, I'm a lot lighter than Dave Lipson.
Right.
I'm a lot older.
Yes.
And so, if you know, he's the guy that has to prove something because I'm the old guy. I'm the light guy. You know, he's just beating up on the old grandpa. So he's the one that has to really prove something. But I think that if, you know, and it kind of comes back to the same thing. Yes, they're going head-to-head, and yes, it's exciting and a lot of fun. But I think the big thing that they'll probably be keeping in mind is their previous best.
Right. And it's anybody's game. I mean, we also have to look at, you know, any day, any hour.
Right.
You know, these guys could go head to head and it might be a different story. I mean, we'll see what happens here, but
I'm sure that there's some purists from the Ole world that are probably going to be watching this and shudder just a little bit at the thought of this, but it is in fun, and it is something that most CrossFitters are quite adept at doing and very familiar with.
Right. And we also know that technique that they do have is going to help them, so it's not that they're just going to.
Okay, let's listen for Castro. He's going to give them the countdown and make the final announcements. Let's listen for that.
Dave Lipson, 6 foot, 215. Josh Everett, 5'9", 185. Isabel, this is a 60-kilo lift. It is 30 reps per time. We're going with a big strike zone. We're not doing the old game standard with C in the ear. The barbell just has to get overhead. Arm has to be locked out. Hips and knees open.
Let's hear it for these guys. Come on. 10 seconds.
Okay, we are almost underway.
3, 2, 1, go!
Wow. Both athletes very, very explosive. They're going head to head, matching each other stride for stride.
Yeah, you can hear that barbell touch the ground at the same time.
Wow, look at that. It's going to be interesting to see who kind of breaks first and who slows down a little bit and starts to pull back.
10 reps in 15 seconds.
10 reps in 15 seconds. You can see the clock
way ahead,
kind of in the background.
15 reps in 26 seconds.
Wow. I think both of them are going to break that minute mark.
17 reps. 18 for Josh Everett.
18 reps for Josh Everett. There's 19.
20 for both.
Look how strong and explosive they still are.
Yes.
Josh Everett has a tight lead.
Losing some reps, and Josh Everett has the lead right now.
Let's break it down a little bit, having to press out.
Both athletes are going to take a second and regrip. So we're getting into the later stages of this workout. 56 seconds, 57 seconds.
Yeah, if you're looking at them pressing out those last few inches every time to get that bar overhead.
Yeah.
Lipson fell behind on a rep there as well.
Josh Everett did beat his previous best by about 4 seconds. Dave was slower, and it was almost a dead tie. Very, very cool. Two great competitors. They were going stride for stride there. Unbelievable. And if you think that's easy, folks, go grab 135 pounds, try to take it overhead in a little over a minute. Look at that. Very, very cool. Photo finish, and there's Josh Everett right there. laughing awesome. And joking. If he's still standing at the end of that.
We need to go back to the instant replay and see you finish. That was a tie. That was outrageous.
Maybe we should have him do it again.
Okay, here's the photo finish. And we'll see.
Wow.
It looks
and you
like
can see Josh really made sure on that last rep that he was fully locked out overhead yeah. and there was going to be no question.
And it looks like Josh got him right there at the end.
Yeah, he really did. And if you saw Dave Lipson where he broke down, was really getting that bar up overhead, but then really having 6 inches to press it out at, you yeah. know, for those last 10 reps, which that's going to add up a lot.
Right, right.